Good afternoon. I wanted to take a moment today to speak to the grief in our midst and the pain that is in our community. The graphic video of the murder of George Floyd on a Minneapolis street at the hands of those who were entrusted to protect him has rocked us to our core. We have long known that historic patterns, systems, and institutions of racism continue to plague our republic, but right now, 328 million Americans and countless people across the world just became witnesses to a murder. And the question is, what will be our testimony in this courtroom of representative democracy? My testimony begins with deep contrition. To our residents whose lived experiences have sparked fear of law enforcement and who have been deeply impacted by white supremacy and institutional injustice, I am sorry. I've been an elected leader at the local level for many years, and we have done meaningful work to improve outcomes and to advance justice, but it's not enough. And we have a moral imperative to be better and to do more. In politics, it's nearly a compulsion to be defensive. Our instinct is to reinforce our records and to point to the work that we have done. But I don't think that attitude can facilitate the conversations that must happen right now for our society and our community to advance, and for our social contract to be renewed so that our whole society can be enfranchised in liberty and belonging. So instead, I want to say two things. One, I don't have all of the answers. And my lived experience disqualifies me from attempting to answer these questions alone. Two, I am wide open to the feedback we hear and reforms that are recommended. I am committed to engaging these deeply rooted issues with transparency, urgency, and together with you, our community, and in particular with our African American community and our communities of color. I attended a peaceful rally in Gresham on Sunday, which was organized by students from Gresham, Reynolds, and Centennial High Schools. I was moved by the sobering and passionate stories that were shared. In addition to these acute issues of safety and police violence, they expressed a longing to belong in a community. And while I acknowledge the painful truth that for many, it may not feel like it, I want to reinforce that this is your city. This is your police department. I know that the burden is on us to build that trust, and that trust only comes after meaningful changes and reforms are in place. I intend to work earnestly to do just that. Yesterday, I signed a national mayor's pledge to take action by reviewing police use of force policies. They include engaging our community by including a diverse range of input, experiences, and stories. It has accountability in reporting those findings of the review back to our community, and it seeks feedback on the policy changes. The work starts now. Next week, I'm convening a group of African American community leaders here in Gresham for a candid, honest conversation. I will share the content of that conversation with you on my social media channels and, of course, the city's YouTube channel. To be clear, this will be the first conversation, but it will most certainly not be the last one. We have a lot of work ahead of us, and we must engage that work with expediency. My pledge is to approach this process by seeking first to listen and truly hear the full range of voices in our community. Gresham is one of the most diverse cities in Oregon, and we can lead the way in building a better America marked with more justice, wider liberty, love for our neighbors, and true belonging. I'm ready to get to work. Are you?